So players getting on Smashville. Are they ready? They are ready. The match is starting right now. Second quarter, loser that Mars 2016. Omega against Alexiao. Let's go!
So two very rare characters in France, especially Greninja, even though we've seen him a lot on the streams of finals of various tournaments at which he has already traveled. Omika, for his part, has only been to tournaments in the south of France and always plays very well, either top 1 or top 2, if Nif was in attendance. Right now it's looking very good for Omika, putting up a real wall, blocking Alexiao at the edge.
Oh! Was nobody it's still on him! Really nice. He won't let Luma get too close to Rosalina, now he got the momentum. And now he lost it. Nice, really nice.
Nice neutral to up smash, solid damage. And Rosalina being so light, she cannot afford to take too much of those. Oh, nice pivot grab.
Too bad for Alexiao, missing the stars. Nice up smash.
And we can see Omika creating some sort of space zone around him everywhere he is on the stage. By not moving too fast, he's just making sure that Alexiao has to pay a high price to get close enough to him. He will spam that down B.
Oh! He's dead now.
Yeah, the shuriken just finding its way between two waves of the down B from Rosalina and killing Luma.
Now Luma is dead, he's rushing on Rosalina.
Hey, no, it's God.
Oh,
and
nice
down smash will take it. Rosalina is one of the lightest characters in the game. You cannot afford to get hit by Greninja's strong smashes.
And Alexiao getting on the passion style. Just throwing a lot of shurikens on Rosalina just stopped. And Alexiao just stunned it! Nice. Getting an opening of that neutral air, he missed it, so getting far away, just already throwing another wave of shurikens. But get that throw from Omika, but still making it back.
Omika trying to clip the two frame with the down smash, no success though. Nice frame try by Alexiao going for a
wow. Super nice back air, just throwing Luma a bit on the edge and then side B to catch both of Rodalina and Luma and get the stars out.
Now, speaking of stars, it's looking like another line for Omika as he struggles to find something to connect with
nice,
like a dashing up smash, but Luma didn't take part into this up smash, so it didn't kill Greninja. No punish. Yeah, Omika is definitely learning the matchup right now. He doesn't understand exactly where and when Greninja needs to be punished.
Oh, nice.
Okay, two pummels, getting as much percent as he needs.
Ouch! As much out of shield, just right after that dash attack. Nice, really nice neutral air.
Okay, Alexiao trying to go for some sort of big read. Ooh. If he manages to take this stock right now, Omika is in a world of hurt. What the hell?
Nice and B, normal Luma. And boom! You take the edge once, not twice.
Looking bad for Omika, trying to collect himself, watching Alexiao rolling around him. Astro will not take it, very close though.
Really nice by Alexiao, coming back on stage, he managed to make it. Nice neutral, I just saw the star, just Luma moving a bit.
And
just
Luma flying back to her master, saying, Greninja, you need to get out of here real quick, you are at 180%, that's way too much.
Once again, taking some distance. He's not in a rush. Nice dash attack. Nice upper. The air dodge to avoid the second one. Still. Oh, down throw.
Up smash. Okay, no. This might have been an opportunity for Omika as Alexiao had to air dodge towards the ground. But not enough percent. No conversion, actually.
Nice up smash. Completely making Alexiao move, making his neutral air. Like, just stopping him. Nice
okay, Luma is out of the way with a strong F smash from Alexiao.
Got quite some seconds free now. Nice jab.
Yeah, nice frame trap. Just waiting for the up air. Whoa, very cute.
That was really nice by Alexiao, taking the edge once, forcing our Omika to get trumped, and just taking the edge second, forcing him to take the edge second time, making a hit on him, and for the don't make the kill, but still got the Luma and some 3%.
Okay, oh, this down air clearly wasn't voluntary, or he thought he would land on Luma. Rosalina with Luma cannot spot dodge Greninja's down air and try to punish him afterwards. Because
oh!
Oh, nice placing by Greninja.
Just coming from nowhere, just getting some space, and boom! F smash. Really nice. Alexia also won the first match. It was like 3-1, but Omeka managed to make it back, kind of, 1-1. Maybe now it's gonna be the Omeka counter pick? Yeah, it changed some stage. So
okay, not to surprise this stage. Although we might think this is a good stage for Greninja, since he's such a fast character with a heavily reliant on his eye rolls. It's actually one of his worst picks. He doesn't even benefit from the platforms like Sheik's do, because he cannot connect with both hits of his up smash when the opponent is standing on the platform. So overall, it's just a nuisance for Greninja. His shuriken pressure game and dash grab game is hindered by the fact that the opponent can jump around and kind of circle jump around him. Right now though, Luma taken out very quickly. And Omeka is struggling to find his way back at the center of the stage.
Alexio trying to run on him, he wants to catch him before Luma is back, but now he's already back. Missing a bit his forward, I'm pretty sure he was aiming at Luma to kill him, because I think it was close enough from the edge to get the kill on that star.
Okay, so a very slow paced game actually, like 1 minute went by and only 30-50% of both players. Omeka, yeah, watching quietly. When we see Omeka set, it's a...
Oh!
Whoa, nice one! Double frame track, like read two air dodges in a row.
Catch with that up there, unfortunately, don't put the strong head on Harmony. Rosalina.
Yep.
Sorry, not the same name.
Wow, could have lost this time.
Too bad, on his first hit, not the second one. Nice trade by Omeka, completely saved his life on that point.
And the jab will put so much pressure when you're stuck in between Luma and Rosalina. At one point, you will get shield poked.
Nice dash attack after that little jump.
Yeah, the dash attack actually got buffed too, a little less lag, so it's kind of harder to punish, but still you should be able to shield grab it if you know the correct timing.
Nice one.
Okay, so Luma was out for the count.
Alexio just playing a bit, just waiting. He doesn't know really how to attack. It's really hard to attack a Rosalina, in fact. If you just make it the wrong way, you're dead. So just waiting a bit, waiting to make his opponent make a mistake, something, but unfortunately, it's not coming.
Yes,
not coming at
nice.
All.
Throwing Lua just a mid-distance away from him as to cover the get-up from the edge and a potential jump from the edge. The F smash will not take it. Oh, it will! Too bad. It was a pretty good DI by Omeka, and we even saw his jump all the way in the loop, but he still lost the stock.
I think too bad the Luma would just stay up there on that platform. If you just fall down, he will hit that side B, and that's gonna won't be the stock.
Jab. Jack destroys shield so badly.
Oh, getting that neutral. Oh, nice spacing on that up smash. Omeka trying to get it. Nice neutral air.
Omeka trying to get out with a down air. Nope. Just retreats to the edge. Doesn't want to give up stage control for an edge guard. He's still in a very good situation as to if he can take this stock fairly quickly. And the jab will take it.
Wow! Now Luma was really well placed to put that on the Greninja. Really, really nice.
So 26%, whoa, nice one. Just doubles the percent, just like that. 30 more percent on Rosalina off of a neutral
air. Really nice. I love all Alexio just jump between Rosalina and Luma and then neutral air, just pull them away, and that's gonna be really hard, but no.
Just a very, very small punish. Luma was waiting there after the grab, so Alexio was afraid to go for anything harder.
Really smart down air just to get away after that pressure.
Okay, the throw again, sitting in shield because he's afraid of Luma hitting him, as he should be. We've seen very recently in an American tournament, Mr. R losing a stock at 0% because of a double hit from Luma from the ground all the way to the top.
Whoa.
And oh wow, reads the air dodge but does not connect with the front air.
He won that kill so bad!
Wow, this Tomahawk was the longest one I've ever seen. Omeka was so scared, he stayed in his shield for a full 3 seconds.
Nice punish. Just turning around, waiting, jumping around, trying to find a way to get him. Nice by Omeka, nice defense on neutral air once again. But no, too late. Nice shield.
Rosalina is a rage monster, but still, it's looking kind of rough for Omika. He could die by a lot of things right now. Even a neutral air sweet spot might take it.
Just pay the four there. Oh!
Okay, it's a full jab combo for a little more percent. Tries to scare him into thinking he would clip the true frame.
Make it a jab. Oh!
Okay. Definitely reads
it. Oh my god! He got the top three. He could have get the kill maybe, but unfortunately Little Man was still here.
Rosalina with his own version of the Shoryuken, and Omika, well, should be rather happy about that because he had a huge deficit in the entirety of this stock, but still managed to get... Oh, nice one! Beginning to read Alexiao's telegraphed rolls. Obviously, he is going to switch it up, but still good on Omika to be able to catch on in the midst of the game. Up smash, no dodge, and Alexiao will not commit to an air dodge ever if he's in this situation at low percent. He knows even if he gets hit by that smash, it's only a few more percent. He does not want to get thrown back off stage, or even worse, something like spiked.
It's really hard to Alexiao to just land on the ground. Omika completely get the control of that stage right now. Just moving a bit, a little bit more in the inner stage, forcing Alexiao to get back, taking a hit on the shuriken, but still making a punish at Luma. Nice throw.
And right away, as Alexiao manages to get back stage control, he tries to force Omika on the side of the stage, and finding some success. Finally, the famous neutral to up smash for a clean 30%.
Yeah, putting him in a really bad situation right now. Already away, now Luma is back, but still jumping in that neutral there. Wow, we'll be getting a little bit, some step back, and that could have been really dangerous.
Greninja, being a fast follower and having a very short hitbox, manages sometimes to get out of Rosalina's jabs, much like what happened right now.
Just slashing Luma as hard as he can. Nice dash attack. Still living for the Luma at the upper. Now you're dead, Luma! Nice forward throw.
Death throw, trying to put some pressure off stage. This might be it, okay.
Wow.
This could have been it.
Wow, again, wow,
the player is choking very hard. The smashes are sent in the wrong direction.
Whoa, they're gonna be hard. Nice. Waiting a bit, taking his time.
Very nice one.
He went for his usual edgeguard pattern, which is standing very close to the edge and scaring his opponent of rolling in. So, much like what he did in the rest of the game, Alexiao jumped from the edge. And this time he tried to mix it up. Instead of landing on the small platform, he landed on the top platform. But still, Omika made sure that he had his double jump and he was floating in the air. I could cover both options, either with a back air or an up air. It takes the second match of this set.
So, now we got like 1-1. It was the Omika counter big, but now we are back on Smash Veil. I assume one of the favorite, maybe the favorite stage of Alexiao. We catch Luma really as fast as he can, that dash attack. Really nice one.
Yep, very clean. Thank you, Luma, for being there for a range total of 3 seconds. A lot of characters have good burst options like that dash attack, sometimes F tilt, that get rid of Luma very easily.
Once again, the
and again, and Alexiao seems to have noticed it, and he will go for it, since Luma has been quite an annoyance, especially with jabs and uppers.
Roll it out, but get those jab. That was a nice grab. Nice try.
Yes, yeah, tries again to get rid of the Luma with the dash attack, but misspaces just a little. Again,
he wanted so bad.
And he's actually overcommitting a little of his dash attacks, but does not get punished too badly by Omika. Omika, on the other hand, is like, okay, you're gonna get rid of my Luma very easily, but on the other hand, personally, I won't approach you if I don't have Luma, so get ready for a long match.
Nice affair.
No
dodge.
You're
gonna come from that way. Oh, the back here?
And this is scary because Rosalina doesn't have a lot of lag on her smashes, and if she does get the true frame with the charge F smash with Luma, it could result in a stock. So you really don't have much of a choice. You need to mix up your recovery as much as you can as to not get clipped by this.
That was a really nice dash attack. Not kill the Luma though, but still. Ouch! After that neutral air, nice fair. But
Luma is out for the count.
Just slashed him.
care. He will jump again from the edge. Omika is definitely catching on to that, but this time did not commit to anything and finds a neutral air to double jump up air with Greninja. Okay, reads as get back towards the center of the stage, but does not punish it.
Really nice. Give him some space. You don't want to do that stuck right now. You really need to make a lot of presentation.
Whoa, nice one.
Oh. Whoa. Still living though.
The edge guard was attempt was not very clear on Omika's part, but still did not get punished for it.
No Luma running for a grab.
Exactly. It's like, and Omika on the other hand, No Luma running for the platform.
See you. Nice fair.
Gets clipped. And that's the person Elixir really wanted. It's always bad for your moral if you're kill the opponent and then don't manage to get even 1% on the advantage you had on the stock in advance.
That was smart, kind of by. Oh, that up smash though!
Yeah, the raw up smash. Like he read, okay, you're in shield, you're gonna drop this and do something, like roll away or anything. And I'm right there with my up smash. Reads again the jump from the edge, but Omika mistimes it.
Really nice. Following the two rolls of Alexiao. Not the first time make it to get the inner stage. So I catch it. Nice double up there. Waiting a bit. Nice here on the Luma. No more Luma.
And again, Omika will sit there and just wait. A very patient player gets... Pivot grabs though, sent up. Yeah, and that's the main problem with Greninja's up smash. It's really wonky on the platforms. It's very hard to connect with the second useful part of it.
Nice dash tech. Won't be able to kill. Nice.
Yeah. Waits for the dodge and gets a second up air. And Rosalina, being a fair and balanced character, takes the stock at only 54%.
Oh my god! Elixir was in the lead, but now he's down to one stock!
And this is huge because, as we said, both these players are very patient. When you manage to get such a lead, and you know your opponent is going to camp when he doesn't have Luma, this can get very hard on your nerves. So right now, it's Elixir versus his own nerves and Omika's great patience and wall of defense that he's putting up.
Nice up throw. And it's back. Oh, just stopping that up smash to come.
Yep, and Omika will not have any problem with just camping very far back and dealing with shurikens with his down B.
Nice back here, trying to catch him, but Omika just roll away. And nice up smash! Get that stuck! And now we're back. Lexio a little bit late on 48%, not that much, but still the stock pretty holy, just the stock before. So, he's in danger.
So jab will ground Greninja down for a clean 16% or something like that. Neutral there.
Wow, nice one! Knew you're gonna roll there.
Omika is really catching on to Alexio's pattern, especially from the edge. He just keeps getting hit by his uppers.
Omika making a really great job with those jabs, always stopping Elixir when he comes. Nice back here, catching both of them. No more Luma.
Yeah, Luma is out.
Nice down tilt, really nice.
Omika, wow. Very patient, reading Elixir's shield. He knows he's afraid and does not want to get hit too much before Luma is back. Nice F shield! It might actually have been an F smash, I'm not too sure. Whoa, trades with a get-up attack, nearly kills thanks to Luma's high knockback moves.
Avoiding the fairy nose is gonna be really dangerous getting hit by any moves right now. Approaching the Luma.
Sending Luma as a projectile.
Nice, really nice, really important that they hit Luma. But those jabs will be enough to get that stock and get that match. 2-1 for Omika.
So reads on Omika's pattern. Phenomenal, like he read Elixir's movement all the way from the edge towards the left side of the stage. He went for the clean punish. I know I can get you with a jab even though I might be too late for an up smash. So here, take this, and it actually took his stock.
Very nice. Yeah, all those jabs by Omika was so nice. Always just moving a bit, jabs, always Elixir just run on it. Maybe Elixir was a little bit too aggressive on the end, I think. Maybe just lost a bit of the momentum somehow in the match.
Definitely. Well, I think he really got shook by the air players that killed him at 50%.
Yeah, probably. Yeah.
When you see like that every percent you get, every juggle you get is such a chore to find. Like you have no opening. Omika and Rosalina are not giving you anything. You know that if you lose those chucks so early, just like when you get spiked by, at 30% by Captain Falcon, you're like, wow, and now I'm going to eat all his combos, and it really gets on your nerves, and you really have to stay focused. We'll see if Elixir manages to keep his cool for the remainder of this set.
So, once again, wow, he didn't wait a bit like the match earlier, just run on it, dash attack, and get Luma out.
So right now he's Rosalina on her own versus... Oh, nice one! Upper fast fall! And this is, well, wow, something Elixir is working on. These combos, these optimized punishes, trying to get something. Still got enough percent and momentum off of that to just be able to take it off, take it easy.
Nice here. Taking some distance, waiting a bit, that dash tag of Harmony just trapped a bit Elixir on the edge, but nice get up.
Yeah, Elixir is finally starting to mix up his recoveries from the edge.
Oh, wrong way. Get on the platform. Taking some distance out. Nice back here. Let's see in the middle.
Whoa, and gets the pair. Double jump read. I'm sorry, but this was, wow, very impressive from Elixir. Instead of going for his usual front air dodge read, he went for the double jump upper read and got the stock at only 90%.
He wanted it so bad. Getting all the stock with an up air.
Only 44%, and this is very reminiscent of what happened at the other match, except, well, Omika got it at 40%, but this very early up air kill allows the one who got it to get a huge momentum boost.
Taking some distance, really nice. Just playing that fair, at least normal Luma. Oh, not now, I mean. Nice, oh, really nice down tilt.
And it's like it is a completely different game, but right now, Elixir is not scared at all of Omika. He's not being forced into any kind of punishable roles. He's just putting a lot of pressure and getting a lot of good, clean percent. But right now, Omika still reading one of those rolls, getting a small throw.
Oh, too bad he uses shield on that dash tag. Even if there's no Luma, there's still two hits. Nice dash tag, unfortunately misses the Luma on that one.
Yeah,
but
Luma
still, like,
right above the ground, so saved from this this tragic history.
Like a shark just waiting on the ground. You wait.
And this is tough for Omika. He might actually die to one of Greninja's strong moves. Or just by another up air way up in the air.
That jab.
The gentle star will not kill yet.
Wow! Nice air dodge fast fall. Just to avoid the lost. Once again, just pacing that four there. But... Oh no! They both laugh of it. At it. Nice, nice neutral air. Once again, just smoothing down that platform, just making a lot... Just... Like positioning pressure. It's just under you. This is really bad for you. And just
down
wait.
Tilt. We'll probably take it, I'm not sure. Yeah, Greninja cannot make it back from that far, even with his side B2 up B recovery. So Omika in a little bit of trouble, but as we've said and as we've seen, still made good use of his rage in the earlier matches. So we'll see if he's able to pull something like that again. Pull off something like that again, sorry.
Avoiding the floor there, the jump to leave it higher than Greninja can jump. No, nice throw. Missed into the water. Let's go, Omika, but catch it.
It's been like three times in the entirety of this set that Omika has been scared to go back on stage and actually retreat it back to the edge. And it's been two times he's died for it, so he might need to just pick other options and roll from the edge or something like that. Even though it is punishable, he needs to mix up his recoveries.
Just turning around, but nice job stopping the movement of Elixir. We'll go back on stage. Yeah, oh, nice pilgrim.
Slick movement.
Once again, stick with that shield. Show them neutral air like that. They both prepare it right now.
Alexia will not dodge, as we've said. You really need to put a huge lot of pressure if you want him to dodge and get hit by one of your moves. You need to just go for it.
Nice battle maker catching Alexia on that landing, but don't fall there.
Very confident in his pacing, no dodge.
Wow, wow, wow! That was really close. Oh, really nice catch of that jump. And once again, that jab just stopped Alexia.
Regular get up from the edge, and Omika was not ready for that. Or at least he read a jump after what?
Nice fair. Shuriken getting some more pressure and the kill! Luma with that shuriken, just enough.
Back throw near the edge, will not be it.
Might take a lot of time to come back. A lot of time with Luma again before he's gonna come back.
Absolutely. Omika is kind of okay with situations where he throws the opponent off stage and not kill him because, as you've said.
No!
Oh, nice one! Loses Numa right away, but goes for a reverse up smash and gets rid of Alexiao's second stock.
Alexiao wanted it. He wanted it so bad. He's rushing on him. He won't let him move, let him go.
Nice one. Fair fast fall to pop his opponent up and then down smash to confirm off of it.
Catch that back here.
And Luma actually extending the hitbox of the back here.
Too bad, two opportunity to kill the Luma, but always a little bit misspaced move, and probably won't get Luma out right now.
And gets jabbed to infinity. Nice pair, and this time, yeah, this time Alexia will be forced to air dodge, and he chooses in the end to neutralize on the stage on Omika's waiting.
Really nice catch on that Luma movement, and then on the Omika movement when he was landing. Nice forward smash, get the match, 2-2.
Very clean smash by Alexiao. He just read Omika's landing, saw the timing on it, and he was like, okay, right now, even if you are a dodge, you will get hit by my smash, and even if you do a back air, we will trade, and you will lose the game. So, what's it? Is what? It like 2-2? I mean,
yeah, it's 2-2.
Wow.
And like Omika won the last match on Smashville, not on Battlefield, it seems can pick it again.
Well, since it's a full list stage of kings, there's even no DSR, so what we might see is a switch from one of the two players. Yep. Alexiao is thinking about his pick and he might go for his Ryu. He has been working his Ryu recently. He actually went all Ryu in a monthly in Paris, but still goes back to his Amphibie, not confident enough in his other picks.
He's still on his Greninja to go on Champ Bataille.
This is France. We speak Champ Bataille here.
So let's go. Once again, that was. I don't remember if that was really close or not, but that was a hard match.
Yeah, it definitely was a easier. The easiest match that Omika won was on a Battlefield by a fair margin. But right now, went for a super hard read. Like, next level, you're going to double jump and I'm going to down air you for it. But missed, so well.
Nice, really nice throw. Already down on the ground, waiting a bit, up throw once again. Still on the ground, waiting, jumping like a frog, that is.
Finally, Omika gaining stage control, and this is terrifying when you face Rosalina on Battlefield. When she has her feet on the ground in the center of the stage, you're in for a world of her to get back in. Her up smash covers so many options, her up air covers the platform so well.
Not threatening this time, the up smash, and finally in the shield. Up throw. Already on the ground, waiting a bit, nice up air. I'm gonna build the person.
This is scary, yeah, Pomika.
Whoa! No take!
You need to learn how to take when you play Rosalina. Much like Fox players, your up B is so vulnerable. This is like your third recovery move, your R button.
Oh, nice spacing by Alexiao, but still getting catched by that dash tag, the second one. Omika winning that up air. Chop on the platform, but now back on the ground. Nice neutral air, superring both on them. Nice up smash right after it, following her after dropping her on that top platform. Was really nice.
This is looking grim for Omika if he doesn't manage to find something huge to get rid of. Whoa, upper fast fall, but the platform messes him, messes with Alexiao. Does not see that this platform could have led to something else, but not to a down tilt.
Too bad, it could have been the up smash somehow. Nice forward smash, no more Luma, nice upper by Omika, now he's dead!
You need to commit to these uppers sometimes, even if you don't have Luma, if you go for the strong hit of Rosalina's upper, you can get killed.
Nice controller catching the roll, dash deck right now. Once again on that landing, nice air dodge, winning a bit. And that get up. Dash attack, really nice. Dropping Luma, pushing him away just a bit. Letting Rosalina a bit defenseless at that point.
And again. Well, Eliseo is being very serious about how he handles the matchup. He's not joking around. He's like, okay, Rosalina is over there, but whatever. I'm going for Luma. I just want to make my life.
Wow!
Very nice spacing.
Just on the ollie of the shield, but moving really well on that landing. Just land really far away from Rosalina, avoiding the grab or all the kind of punish.
Omika is right now struggling, finds a jab. He needs to make better use of his stage control. In the other match that he won on Battlefield, he was much more efficient at punishing Eliseo when he held the center of the stage.
Oh, the jab.
And as I say that, it's been a while since Omika has been hit, and it's been a while since he has a stage control, so he might actually be improving in the midst of this match in regards to stage control.
Nice back here, and now no more Luma for quite some time, and now he's starting to make some pressure on Rosalina. He can now. Nice.
Rosalina being shot by Greninja's up air.
Already back on the ground, nice up tilt. You want to catch it so bad. He went on the platform just in case that he jumped. Apparently it won't happen, so you get him back on stage and still getting the pressure. No more Luma once again. Wow, nice catch on that jump.
Omika being stuck in shield, he really wants the stage control. Finds an up throw and gives up stage control for it. Gets back right where he was before on the platform. But Luma is now back, so this might be Omika's opportunity. Too slow on the up smash, he didn't even go for an up smash out of shield, he dropped his shield way too slow to punish Greninja's buff dash attack.
No more Luma once again, nice fair, but unfortunately mystery the waking up option by Eliseo. Nice neutral air, no up air, but still making the pressure, and yeah, and an up smash of that out dodge! He takes it and makes it Omika down on 3-2.
Very, very convincing last game, actually. This was like super close. Each player had a decent lead when on the match that he won. And at this match, it was a huge lead. Omika had a lot of trouble when he was stuck on the platforms. He just couldn't get back in the center of the stage. And he had to let go of this victory and this spot in the loser's bracket.